Welcome to The Forensic File, a series that explains the science, technology, and methods of the modern digital analyst.
Hi, I'm Doug Carner, President of Forensic Protection Audio Video Enhancement Authentication, and lead programmer on VideoCleaner, the world's most relied upon forensic image and video enhancement and authentication tool, relied upon by more private analysts and law enforcement than any other software of its kind in the world. Simply launch the program, press F5 to select what you want to work with. In this case, we'll take Dark from the VideoCleaner samples folder. Let's go ahead and put the before and after atop each other and turn on the tools section. Right off the bat, it's hard to see any details, so we'll turn on the histogram, and let's also correct the backlighting. We can fix the focus with a little deblur, and let's go ahead and sharpen those details. While we're at it, let's give it a little more contrast between the light and dark areas. It looks pretty good, but I'd like it to be even clearer. So I'm going to move down to the forensic section, turn it on, and let's give it a little edge detection. And there it's easy to see the difference between a before and after. Let's move on to another example. From the VideoCleaner samples folder, let's open XVID. We'll go ahead and have the before and after atop each other, just as we did before, and we'll make it so that we can see the tool section clearly. First thing we want to do is turn on that tool section and turn on the histogram to again make it possible to see what's in the video. As we move through it, we can see it's a license plate, but it's very difficult to make out what is the details of this particular plate. So what we're going to go ahead and do is turn on a little of the contrast. Let's take it about halfway. And let's also have the color be a little stronger. Maybe that'll help a bit. And already it's a little bit better, but we still have the problem with all these pixels being distorted between each frame. Well, there's a tool for that as well. We move down to the forensic section, turn on the section, and we're going to frame average. And since our video is 100 frames long, we'll go ahead and average for 50. We can now move through this video. It is continuing this averaging all throughout. And now we're able to easily make out what the plate says. Let's go ahead and move on to another example. Here we have a video that is open, but as you can see, the fields are shifted. Fields occur when the camera takes an image and then takes another image and puts the two together by weaving those moments in time to create one frame. This is very common in older systems. The other issue we have is as we advance through the video by moving the right arrow key, we can see that it alternates between good frames and garbage. This is because those alternating frames were actually metadata and other types of information that couldn't be processed by VideoCleaner. And although it was able to open this proprietary file, we only want the video content. So the first thing we're going to do is let's fix up the alignment of the frames. We're going to move down to the properties section. And from within there, we're going to go to the fields. We're going to turn on the fields and we're going to move this alignment. We can move it a little more, and we get a clear picture. Next, we can continue down and go to the desequencer, and we have a video currently that's 200 frames long here, but we turn on the desequencer and tell it to use frame 0 as a reference, which is the default, and now we have a video 102 frames, and as we move to the right arrow key, we just have good video. You could use this if you have a video that alternates between one camera, then another, and then another. Now that we have this, let's go ahead and make the video a little easier to look at. Let's move on up to our tools section. This is where you're going to find most everything you ever work with in VideoCleaner. And we'll turn it on and let's sharpen this a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and move that over. We'll just take it to about 20. And we'll turn on the contrast, take that up to about 10. You can see that even with the settings I have on, the computer's being very responsive here. We can take our color contrast up a bit. We can turn our backlight compensation. and we can turn our denoiser on. And we have a much more viewable scene than we had before. We can even come back down into our property section. So we're going to go ahead and scroll down here. And we can turn on the resize and apply some super resolution. So now we have achieved the greatest level of details possible. Now we're going to come back up to the top, and I'm going to go ahead and put the before and after atop each other. Keep in mind that the de-interlacing that we provided and getting rid of those bad frames will apply to both the original and the enhanced to make them a one-for-one match. But we can see that in the original, things aren't as pronounced, they're not as crisp down below. It's a little easier to make out what's happening, the correct colors, see the details. And if we want to know what features are on at any time, we can just move over this slider, and it will list all active features. And we can see that we have the tools, the fields, the resize, and the desequencer on. Let's move on to another example. Here we have a video from a case. The cell phone video was completely saturated by the blue light. We can see there's a face here. We just can't make out the details. So let's go ahead and improve that. First, we're going to go ahead and put the before and after side by side so we're able to compare what we're able to end up with. Now, right off the bat, we have learned that by turning on the tool section and moving down here, we're going to turn on the histogram. Generally, that gives really good light levels. And right away, we see we have a much more usable facial features here. We can also turn up the color contrast to give a little more intensity here. We can sharpen this picture. And we can apply unsharp as well. And I'll let the user's manual explain the difference between those, but they each offer something. Now, the next thing we want to do is let's come down here and let's bend the light, which is the curve section. And this one, we can just bend it down a little bit, make it a little bit darker, a little more contrast. Here I have an image that's fairly clear, but I want to know if it's been manipulated. So I move down to the analysis section, and let's go ahead and run the discrete cosine transform, and there are our results, but they're really dark. Now, I have a couple ways in which I can make it brighter. We've used the tool section to make things brighter. We've used the curve section to make things brighter, but this time let's use the equalizer section. So we'll take this, and I'll just turn its strength all the way up, and there are my results. I can see that there's no noise on the three monitors and this portion of the wall. Therefore, I know that that's where it was manipulated. Someone took this into a photo editing program and did post-production manipulation. I won't know what was there. I'll just know that this is not an authentic image. And this is just some of the samples of the power of what you can do with VideoCleaner.